The Education Department awaiting the advice of health authorities regarding calls for a so-called health break in schools. The Alliance of Concerned Teachers and the Teachers as Dignity Coalition have been pushing for a two-week academic break in areas under alert level 3 amid the rising number of infections among students, faculty, and other school personnel. But DepEd Secretary Leonora Briones says they will have to take into account the health department's risk assessment. She also cited how a health break may affect the required 220 school calendar days. In the meantime, the agency is urging its regional offices and school division offices to exercise discretion in suspending classes amid the continued rise in COVID-19 cases. The Ateneo de Manila University postpones its plan to resume in-person classes this January. University President Roberto Yap says the postponement covers both undergraduate and postgraduate programs, as well as on-site work. But limited in-person classes in the Ateneo School of Medicine and Public Health, as well as the administration of the bar exams at the Ateneo Law School Rockwell campus, will proceed, with strict adherence, of course, to health and safety protocols. The Philippine Higher Education Commission has said tertiary schools in areas under alert level 3 are allowed to defer the resumption of face-to-face classes if existing conditions are unfavorable. The Commission on Human Rights slams the Transportation Department's no vaccination, no ride policy. The CHR said the rule restricts a person's fundamental right to travel. It adds, the move also prevents the general public from accessing essential goods and services. Village officials instructed to make an inventory of individuals unvaccinated against COVID. The Interior Department says this is in line with President Duterte's order to impose mobility restrictions on those who have yet to get jabbed. The League of Provinces of the Philippines had followed the Metro Manila Council's move to pass a resolution encouraging its members to impose such curbs. An interior official says only the cities of Navotas, Makati, and Pasig have not yet passed local ordinances on the matter in Metro Manila.
We expect that in the next few days ay mapapasa na po ito dahil unanimous naman po yung naging desisyon ng lahat ng mayors ng Metro Manila. It all begins with an inventory. And then pag meron na po tayong inventaryo, doon na po i-implement ng LGU through a ordinance yung mga restrictions sa movement ng mga unvaccinated individuals.
Active COVID cases in the Philippines reach an all-time high. It's now at 208,164 from just 10,000 exactly 2 weeks ago. That's after the health department logged 32,246 more infections Wednesday. The number of new cases is the country's second highest daily tally, next to the over 33,000 that the DOH announced on January 10. Despite the slight drop, authorities say it's still too early to tell if the Omicron-driven surge has hit its peak.
The problem is that we have seen a very small number of sequencing reports over the last month in December, and the last batch of samples were largely from NCR and from returning overseas Filipinos. We need to be aware that we will continue to see total numbers of cases increasing as the virus spreads out into other regions like Region 3, 4A, and even Region 5, Visayas and Mindanao.
Quarantine time shortened in the Philippines despite the continued rise in COVID-19 infections. Based on the latest guidelines from the health department, the isolation period for vaccinated individuals with asymptomatic or mild COVID-19 will be shortened to 7 days starting today, January 13. Their close contacts who are fully vaccinated will only have to isolate for 5 days. Meanwhile, the unvaccinated or partially inoculated that are probable, mild or asymptomatic cases will have to undergo isolation for 10 days. Testing will also no longer be required unless symptoms develop.
From evidence, we also see the continuous rise in the number of cases, that most of the cases remains to be asymptomatic and mild cases, showing the effectiveness of our vaccines against severe disease and death. Also, most recent evidence on Omicron variant also shows that if that it tends to present with milder symptoms. The prolonged quarantine and isolation duration has been causing strain to our healthcare system and our economy. And our experts believe that specifically for the Omicron variant, the benefits of shortening quarantine outweighs the risk. This seems to be consistent with global practice as we see other countries updating its quarantine and isolation processes.
The changes in the isolation period, however, are not sitting well with Philippine College of Physicians President Dr. Maricar Limpin.
Okay lang kung puro Omicron lang kasi parang medyo hindi siya ganun talaga palala, di ba? Pero may kasamang ano Delta variant. So alam natin na ang Delta variant talagang medyo severe ang mga sakit na dulot nito. Eh kung very short yung ano natin, then yung gagamitin natin for the general public, eh baka maraming madisgrasya.
The health department also shifts to targeted contact tracing in Metro Manila to maximize resources amid the latest COVID wave. This means the tracing will now focus on the vulnerable population and less on those who came in close contact with a COVID-positive patient. Some health experts are backing this move, saying it's in accordance with the World Health Organization's policies.
Because of the epidemiologic situation, assessment natin sa ating sitwasyon sa ngayon, because of the very high transmission rate in our community, specifically here in NCR, hindi ho priority ngayon ang contact tracing.
For example, may isang kaso, ang hahanapin mo, meron po ba kayo mga kamag-anak or na-encounter na may comorbidities, matanda, di ba, or bata? So mas specific yung hinahanap natin na ite-trace rather than itatanong mo sino lahat ang iyong nagkaroon ka ng contact.
But the country's contact tracing chief has his reservations on the new policy.
Sana huwag na mag-undermine yung contact tracing because critical pa rin yan doon sa ating strategy. Contact tracing dictates yung testing rate. Ano? The more you contact trace, the more tests you conduct, the higher test that you conduct, you'll be able to seek out yung mga positive.
The shift comes as the Philippines faces a shortage in contact tracers. Just this year, 16,000 contact traces were terminated because of lack of funds. But the DOH says contact tracing will continue, especially in regions where transmission rate is relatively lower. 28 more areas in the Philippines are placed under COVID Alert Level 3. The higher alert level will take effect Friday and will be enforced until the end of the month. Alert Level 3 will cover 60 more Luzon provinces, 7 more localities in the Visayas region, and 5 more areas in Mindanao. The government earlier placed 19 areas, including Metro Manila, under Alert Level 3.